Hi guys, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Software Testing by MKT. In this video, we are going to talk about what do you mean by Scrum. Before I proceed with this video, I want you guys to make sure that you have watched my Agile Methodology video. Link is there in the description. Please check it out and then please come to this video. Let's get started to talk about what do you mean by Scrum. So when we talk about Agile Methodology, it talks about the principles that we need to follow in order to develop any new software. Whereas Scrum talks about the rules to be followed while following your Agile methodology to develop any new software. On the other hand, Agile is also a framework for managing your Agile process. So what exactly happens in Scrum process? Let's discuss this. So in Scrum process, the first thing which you need to understand in Scrum is called as product backlog. Product backlog, it is something which will be prepared by our product managers or product owner. So it is a duty of product manager. See, product manager is someone who will be interacting with our clients or our customer or with our technical team. So it is a duty of my product manager to create the product backlog. Product backlog is nothing but what and all things we want to make in order to give the software to the customer. Like what you know things, we suppose I'm developing any new software. In the product backlog, it is the duty of my product manager to write each and everything. Like what you know things we need to work on it. Like we need to work on login page, we need to work on home page, we need to work on logout page. So he's the person responsible for each and everything that needs to be processed or that needs to be done in order to give the software to the customer. So it's a duty of product manager to create each and everything we need to do in order to give the software to the customer in the product backlog. Now the second thing which we are going to talk about in Scrum process is called as sprint. See, when we are developing any software, we cannot expect or our customer cannot expect us to deliver the full software, full ready 100% software at once to the customer. In order to avoid that, means suppose someone is my client, I cannot give my 100%, I mean full software is ready, please take it. After 1 year, please come and take your full 100% software. So these are not things doesn't happen in IT industry. So how things happen? For that purpose, we follow sprint. The meaning of sprint is, suppose your project is there for 1 year. Now, as a company, we have decided that after every 2 weeks, we are going to deliver a piece of software to the customer. Like every two weeks, 2 weeks is my one sprint. Now, every one sprint, we are going to deliver something to the customer. That is called as sprint. So, suppose we are thinking that our software might take 1 year to finally 100% developed. So we are not going to make our customer wait for 1 year. What we will do? We will follow sprint in order to give the piece of software every 2 weeks to the customer. That is called as sprint. Now the next thing that we need to discuss in Scrum methodology is called as what do you mean by sprint planning. So sprint planning is my meeting conducted by my Scrum Master or my product owner. So Scrum planning is a meeting conducted by Scrum Master or my BA, that is business analyst or product managers, in which they will invite the people from development team, they will invite people from your testing team, they will invite architecture, and they will be having a meeting to make sure that what and all things we need to take from my product backlog and I have to work in this coming sprint. So if you guys remember, product owner had created each and everything that they need to do in 1 year in the product backlog. So as I said, my sprint will be there. Let's say that in my company, I am following that after every 2 weeks, we are going to deliver the piece of software to the customer. So every 2 weeks consists of my one sprint. So in sprint planning, Scrum Master or product manager, they will decide from the product backlog what and all things they need to work in this sprint. They need to assign those tasks, what and all tasks they have taken from the product backlog, right? They will take it and assign it to the developers and test engineers based on their availability time. And also remember, some companies follow sprint planning on the last day of sprint, and some company follow sprint planning on the first day of the sprint. Now the next thing that we need to discuss in Scrum process is called as, what do you mean by Scrum Master? So guys, Scrum Master is a person who is responsible for the delivery of my software to my customer within a planned period of time. That is called as Scrum Master. He is the person who will be responsible for my delivery of my software to the customer within a planned period of time. He is the person who will be working on project management tools like Jira, and he will be creating stories, tasks, and he will be assigning to BAs, developers, test engineers, and he will be tracking all the technical people work, what they are doing. So his job is that. Now the question arises, who can become Scrum Master? So the answer is senior developers, senior test engineers, or my product managers or business analysts. Anyone of this can become Scrum Master. The next thing that we are going to discuss in Scrum methodology is called as, what do you mean by Scrum meeting? So Scrum meeting is a meeting conducted by my Scrum Master on daily basis. It is a meeting conducted by Scrum Master on daily basis, which is strictly bounded for 10 to 15 minutes. It is also called as daily stand-up meeting. BA, developers, test engineers, product managers will be the part of this meeting. In this meeting, we mainly discuss three things. So Scrum Master will be there. He will ask each and every individual testers, developers, product managers that what you did yesterday, what are you going to do today, and when you are doing any work, is there any blocker for you? Is there any obstacle for you? So these are the three things Scrum Master will ask each and every people in the Scrum meeting. The next topic that we are going to discuss in Scrum methodology is called as Sprint Retrospective Meeting. So Sprint Retrospective Meeting, it is a meeting conducted by my Scrum Master at the end of every sprint. As a part of Sprint Retrospective Meeting, Scrum Master will ask each and every member of the team that what went well, what didn't go well, and if something didn't go well, what and all things we are going to do in order to achieve them good in the next sprint. So Sprint Retrospective Meeting is a meeting conducted on the last day of the sprint or at the end of the sprint, when the sprint is over the next day. So he will ask people these questions. The next topic that we are going to discuss as a part of Scrum methodology is called as Bug Triage Meeting. So, Bug Triage Meeting, it is a meeting conducted by my test engineer or the product owner. So, in this meeting, they will invite all developers, all test engineers, and they will have the list of all the open bugs that the test engineers have found out, not only in this sprint, but also from the last sprints which are not resolved. Like all the bugs which are in the open state, they will have all the list of them, all the bugs, and they all will reprioritize it. Like which defects we should fix it first, and which defects which we can fix it in the later sprint. So based on the customer business point of view, which bug is critical, which bug is major, which bug is minor, they will be having a list of all the bugs, right? In that they will decide which and all bugs I need to fix it in this sprint and which and all bugs I can take it to the next sprint. So this bug triage meeting is a meeting conducted by the test engineer or my product owner few days before the release. Suppose my sprint is for 2 weeks, I will conduct my bug triage meeting 1 week before the release, so that as a test engineer I will be able to show my bugs to my whole team, so the team can decide which and all bugs we have to solve as a part of this sprint based on the customer business workflow or based on the how it is impacting the customer business flow, and which and all bugs we can move aside as a that we will work on in the next sprint. The next thing that we are going to discuss here is called as stories. So stories are nothing but it is a feature or any module. The next thing that we are going to discuss here is called as epic. As I said, Stories are nothing but a single feature or a single module, whereas epic is a collection of stories. That means under epic, all my stories are present. Epic is a collection of all my requirement. Epic is the requirement under which there are different features, different modules in it. So one epic can consist of multiple stories in it. The next thing that we are going to discuss here is called as, what do you mean by story points? Talking about story point, it is nothing but a rough approximation given by my developers and test engineers to complete particular task. As a Scrum Master, when I am assigning any task to my test engineers and developers, I will ask them what is the story point for that particular task. So they will give the story point is 2 or story point is 3. How? Each and every company have their own standard to follow story point. Some company say that in their company, one story point is equal to 1 hour. Some company say that in their company, one story point is equal to 1 day. When your Scrum Master is assigning you some task and he is asking you what is the story point, so in that case, you have to give a rough approximation the time which can take in order to complete that task. So you need to say that if you are thinking that process, that task may take 5 hours and your company is following one story point is equal to 1 hour. So you can give 5 story points like that. Always remember, while giving story points, you need to give story points in the form of Fibonacci series. Fibonacci series is nothing but you need to give your number in this now format. That means your story point can be 1 or 0 plus 1 that is 1 or 1 plus 1 that is 2 or 2 plus 1 that is 3 or 3 plus 2 that is 5 or 5 plus 3 that is 8. Your story point should be in Fibonacci series. The next topic that we are going to discuss here is called as swag. Swag is just like your story point, but it is in the form of hours. In the sense, it is a rough approximation given by my developers and tester to complete a particular task in the form of hours. So I hope this video was useful to you guys. If yes, please give a thumbs up to this video. And if you have any questions, you can post your question in the comment section. You can also reach to me. I have added my Gmail ID in the link description. Thank you for watching.